Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It is your queen, divine mother goddess Yamaya, your intuitive guide, and I am going to be doing an intuitive reading for you all today. Today I am not doing a zodiac read. I probably won't be doing it for a little while. I want to try something different. I probably should have did a pull to see what you guys think, but I'm just going out there on a limb and just trying something different. Today is December the 14th. It is 2022, and I'm just going to be doing a reading from the Soul's Journeys deck because that's what I'm feeling like I am being called to do. And so that's what I'm going to be doing. So I already pre-shuffled, and the first card we have out here is guilt. It says, I release any beliefs that no longer assist in my soul's growth. Yeah. And basically persevering past it. It says, I know that I can do whatever I set my mind to. Yeah, so you know that you're able to grow. You know that you're able to fulfill yourself by you accomplishing things that you set your mind to. And you set goals. You are in this energy right now and are in this place where you feel like you've staggered enough. And you know you held yourself back and let yourself down for too long. You could have been feeling a little guilty about that. But now you're choosing to grow past that guilt and persevere past all of the setbacks that you've been mentally constraining and conditioning your mind to go through. It's not something that someone else is doing. This is self-inflicted, and it could have been making you unhappy with happiness in reverse. I am aware that I am being happy means that I am on the right path. So yeah, you felt like you weren't on the right path. You weren't happy yet. You could have had a lack of self-esteem at the time, not knowing where your gifts were. You could have not have been, you know, feeling confident in the gifts that you inhabit within yourself. You could also be feeling really sluggish as well due to health issues, with happiness coming out in reverse as well as with it being green. I take that as a sign connected to health. And so that could be something that is causing you to not be fulfilled as you would be. It's because your health isn't in the greatest condition. We have honesty in reverse as well. You could be going through, I'm hearing spirit say that you could be like suffering from dehydration. You need to drink more water. I'm also hearing like someone is having like a lot of headaches because of them not drinking a lot of water, as well as mentally constraining themselves. They're thinking a lot about a lot, as well as their body is, you know, processing a lot where you need to be hydrated so you won't, you know, shut down. Your body won't shut down from overexerting itself. You could have not wanted to accept what your calling was, what honesty and service in reverse. Yeah, you could have not had a love for what you feel like your service was. Here I'm kind of like, I just got a read similar to this, but it was various signs that came up out of it in the situation. But yeah, it says honesty. Sorry guys, I'm sitting this phone on my lap. I need to give me like a phone holder for my car and drove it in so long. I gotta get everything new. But it says honesty, service in an upright, and love in the reverse. Honesty and love in the reverse. It says, I commit to the practice of seeing the good in all things. Someone is not seeing the good of all in all things. Someone could be being very hateful, as well as spiteful, as well as vengeful. I'm hearing service. Someone could be, you know, ignoring their calling as well. Don't want to accept the truth of their calling. It says, I can't always expect the truth from others, but I can expect it for myself. Someone is not being honest with themselves, as well as what their calling is. So this is someone who needs to step out of fear. Someone needs to step away from fear. When I say step out of fear, step, draw yourself away from it, pull yourself back from it, and actually step up to the occasion. It's time for you to rise above, rise above all that fear, rise above all of that anxiety, rise above all of that questioning yourself and doubting yourself. That is something that someone is inflicting on you. That is a spiritual tactic that someone is waging on you, as far as a spiritual warfare tactic, to cause you to be confused, as well as to question what it is that you should be doing here. But Spirit said, don't have fear. You're facing adversities right now, and you need to have some courage as well as have gratitude, because they are reversing your health for you. Yes, they are. Yeah, because you learned how to forgive yourself, with forgiveness coming out after all of these cards. Yeah, you're learning how to forgive yourself, and you're no longer worried about anything, and you're no longer in denial. You're not worried. You're not in denial. You learn how to forgive yourself with that coming out in the upright. Your health is good, and because of that, mentally your health is good. You have been working through that, so that what I was just mentioning is a past energy, but you've been working past all of those mental constraints as well as those unhealthy habits and mental thoughts that you've had that has been holding you back. And now you are actually improving, because when you improve your mental space, you're able to clean out some of that space. You're able to recollect your thoughts, you're able to get a clearer perspective, and you're able to move forward. And that is something that someone took on and did. So congratulations to you. It was not something, from what I'm seeing these cards, easy for you to do, as change is not easy for any of us to do, but you are working through it and gravitating yourself through that. You no longer are living in fear. You're not worried about anything that you have to take on. You're just taking it on at this time. It says, I realize that I am testing my resolve to live in the energy of love. Yes, and you are choosing to love. Your service is of love. Whatever service you're doing, you could be someone who's a humanitarian. You could also be someone who like advocates for people who's been battered as well as, and that's for men and women as well as children. You could also be someone who is just like a spiritual leader in general. You could run a church of some sort. You could like do tarot, similar to me. You could also do you know, like you'd be like a Reiki healer of some sort, a rabbi, you know. But yeah, you're someone who faces adversity without fear. You have a lot of courage here. You're someone who's very courageous. This could be shunned upon by a lot of people. It says that I find the inner strength to face fear. Yeah, and we have fear in the reverse. You face that. You face fear that came out right after adversity. All of that are challenges as well as things that could draw fear upon someone. When someone is facing adversity, they sometimes shut themselves down because they're so fearful of the, you know, impossibilities of being able to overcome their adversity. But yeah, you have courage. You're also grateful for what you have. You're grateful to your ancestors, and you're, because of your gratefulness, you've had your health reversed. Yeah, because you learned how to love and forgive yourself, and so Spirit was able to open that door for you with gratitude and health in the upright as well as forgiveness. You've learned how to forgive yourself and to heal yourself. You could have been overcoming some you know, childhood traumas as well. You could have some issues with your parents. You could have had like mommy issues, daddy issues, and you know, and not in a sense of like you didn't have them, but it just could have been that you had to, even though they were there, they could have been working a lot or something. You had to raise yourself. Trust, and that could have caused you to not have trust, not only in yourself but in others as well. I accept that my inner voice will always guide me correctly. You are not using your intuition. You could have not been in the past, which was causing you to be imprisoned mentally. I possess the power and the free will to create my own happiness. Yeah, but you wasn't creating your happiness because you weren't sure. And that was holding you back from the abundance that you could have. Yeah. By you not trusting yourself and accepting your gifts for in you for who you are. Yeah. And disciplining yourself. You may have needed to discipline yourself against things that, you know, mental constraints. Like I said, this is all about a mental constraint. This is all about someone who's fighting themselves. Yeah. Someone had an ego to the death, and now they're able to grow. Yeah. Someone was able to grow. It says death. So what could be a Scorpio? It says surrender. So what could be also I'm getting like passion, as well as I'm getting like the fire signs for Leo, Aries, Sagittarius. Growth. It says death, surrender. Someone did away with old ways. This isn't a literal death. This is like death to the ego. Someone surrendered to themselves. It says I release my need to control. Yeah, someone wanted to be in control, but they needed to allow the divine to step in and be in control. Yeah, so that they can have growth. It says I want to expand my consciousness and my awareness. is imagination. It says, I embrace and nourish the creativity, the creative aspect of my mind. Yeah, this is all about your mind here. Someone was having a lot of, you know, mental constraints based off of things and mindsets that they allowed themselves to set up within their head and in their mind space, and they've had to break free of them in order to liberate themselves. Okay, that this could be a situation for you. And if you're feeling like, no, I've always had my stuff together, I've always been good, I haven't allowed myself to break myself down, I've always pushed myself, I've always spoke positive affirmations over myself, I'm in that stage of still doing that to this day, and then this is may not resonate with you, but for those of you who have been in that space of having to work through, you know, self-doubt, having to work through things that you feel like you couldn't accomplish and things that you feel like would set you back if you attempted them, which really was going to get you further, those are the things that you now understand that you are your own worst enemy and you are holding yourself back, and that by getting out of your own way, you're able to push yourself forward, okay? So that is what I have for you guys. I appreciate your attention. Thank you so much for stopping in. Yeah, I like to also say that this could be in reference to a Taurus, Capricorn, or Virgo. Okay, but that is what we have, guys. I look forward to seeing you soon. I'm going to be coming with some more reads later today, so just be on the lookout for them. Maybe I will drop a few zodiacs, but we'll just see. Okay, but until later, I'll see you soon. Bye.